Sarah, there you are. I've been looking for you. The last few days, we've been plagued by paranormal activity inside headquarters. Things keep falling, doors slam shut, and eerie whispers fill these halls. It's almost like something is stalking us. Something malevolent. Whatever it is, it's getting stronger. Take a look around. I'll be around if you need me.
So the rumors are true. Anubis, ruler of the underworld, has been reduced to a tiny tot named Newbie. Ha! In that case, your throne is mine. But I won't stop there. By the new moon, this world shall be mine as well.
Anubis, Lord of the Underworld, is a popular god in Egyptian mythology, often depicted as a black jackal, or a man with a jackal's head. Anubis protected the dead. By deciding who was worthy to enter the realm of the dead, he weighed each person's heart against Ma'at's feather of truth. If it was lighter, and thus pure, Anubis guided the soul into the afterlife. However, many people don't know that Anubis was also the god of embalming, and governed the souls of the dead. Every 5,000 years he was reborn, but his enemies would conquer the underworld. If he did not renew his powers before the new moon, to do so, even Anubis had to cross the river Styx. For this, the fare is not more and not less than 2 coins.
I'm the guardian of the light of life, but a dark force took me here and drained my light. All that's left is this empty vessel. Can you fill it with light? It's my only way to escape.
Cross the river Styx, mortal? The fare is 2 coins.
I'm trapped in this barrier. Thank you. A dark force trapped me using the light of life, which was stolen from your world. Be careful.
You saved me. Please, take my medallion as thanks. It makes any animal obey you.
medallion. Your wish is our command. We shall open the gates of the Hall of Eternity.
Thank you. Thank you.